Good morning. Let's do an elastic collision problem.
Flippin' physics.
But first, it's hat, wig, vest, and sword day.
Hat, wig, vest, and sword day.
I don't get it. Why isn't it just hat day?
Last year on hat day, everybody just wore a baseball cap.
It was pretty boring.
Hence, hat, wig, vest, and sword.
Okay.
Billy, could you please read the problem, and Bo, could you please translate?
Cart 1 has a mass of 2m, and cart 2 has a mass of m.
Pause. I guess mass 1 equals 2m, and mass 2 equals m?
That's fine, Bo. Billy?
Cart 2 is initially at rest. Cart 1 is moving at 40.9 centimeters per second when it collides elastically with cart 2.
Pause. Velocity of cart 2 initial is 0. Velocity of cart 1 initial is 40.9 centimeters per second.
Billy?
If the speed of cart 1 after the collision is 13.4 centimeters per second, what is the speed of cart 2 after the collision?
Velocity of cart 1 final is 13.4 centimeters per second, and velocity of cart 2 final equals question mark.
Thank you. Now let's take a look at the demonstration. The way I calculated the velocities was by measuring the positions of the carts as a function of time and calculating the slopes just before and after the collision. Also, the question uses speed and we have used velocity. We can do this because the carts are moving at constant velocities and therefore the magnitudes of the cart velocities are the same as their speeds. Bo, how should we solve for the final velocity of cart 2?
Well, we know momentum is conserved during collisions, so the sum of the initial momenta equals the sum of the final momenta. This means mass 1 times velocity 1 initial plus mass 2 times velocity 2 initial equals mass 1 times velocity 1 final plus mass 2 times velocity 2 final. We can substitute in 2m for mass 1, 40.9 for velocity 1 initial, m for mass 2, 0 for velocity 2 initial, and 13.4 for velocity 1 final. Oh, hey, everybody brought masks to the party. Everybody brought masks.
Bo, please keep going.
We can subtract 2 times 13.4 from both sides to solve for velocity 2 final, and we get 55 centimeters per second.
Shouldn't we only have one significant digit on our answer because the mass of cart 1 is 2 times m and 2 only has one significant digit?
That's a good question, Billy. So generally when a given value is a multiple of another given value, then we treat that multiple as an exact number. For example, that 2 we treat as an exact number. Therefore, we should have 3 significant figures on our answer. So our final speed of cart 2 is 55.0 centimeters per second, or if we were to give the final velocity of cart 2, it would be 55.0 centimeters per second to the right. Now we can look at the full graph of position as a function of time for both carts. The slope for cart 2 after the collision, I measured to be 52.8 centimeters per second. So 52.8 centimeters per second is our observed value for the velocity of cart 2 after the collision. We can use the relative error formula now to solve for the error in our measurement. Relative error equals observed value minus accepted value divided by accepted value times 100, and we end up getting negative 4.00% error for our observed velocity.
Mr. P?
Yes, Bobby?
This is an elastic collision, so kinetic energy should be conserved. Can we prove that?
We don't know the mass of either cart, so I don't think we can prove kinetic energy is conserved, can we?
You know what? Actually, we can. We know the sum of the initial kinetic energies should be equal to the sum of the final kinetic energies. Therefore, the ratio of the total kinetic energy final over the total kinetic energy initial should be equal to 1. The total kinetic energy initial equals the sum of the kinetic energies of both carts. In other words, 1/2 times mass 1 times the velocity of cart 1 initial squared, plus 1/2 times mass 2 times the velocity of cart 2 initial squared. Which equals 1/2 times 2m times 40.9 squared, plus 1/2 times m times 0 squared, which equals 1672.81 times mass. And we can do the same thing with the sum of the kinetic energy final using the 52.8 centimeters per second, the observed value for the final velocity of cart 2. We get 1573.48 times mass for the total kinetic energy final. And now we can go back to the ratio of the kinetic energies. With the net kinetic energy final divided by the net kinetic energy initial, you can see that the mass cancels out, and we are left with the number 0.94062, which we can multiply by 100 to express as a percent. In other words, 94.1% of the kinetic energy that existed before the collision remains after the collision. So class, was kinetic energy conserved?
No.
Yes. Maybe?
Yeah, I'm not really sure either. I would say it was pretty close, but if you really want to know, you need to take more trials. Thank you very much.
Hold up a second, Mr. P. I take umbrage with something you just did.
Okay, Mr. Beck, go ahead, take umbrage.
Well, take a look at cart 1. It has kinetic energy of 1672.81 m. That cart looks to be about 517 grams, or 0.517 kilograms. So that would be a kinetic energy of 864.84 joules, because kinetic energy is in joules. But that's not right, because joules are newtons times meters, or kilograms times meters squared over seconds squared, and you used centimeters per second. I think you should have converted your velocities to meters per second.
But wouldn't you agree in this particular case that it does not matter because we take the ratio and the units cancel out?
I will agree to that, if you agree that it is not a good idea to get into the habit of using centimeters when determining energy.
Ah, but we could determine the energy in ergs, or grams times centimeters squared over seconds squared.
Ah, yes, ergs. And have you ever mentioned ergs before?
No.
I rest my case. It is a bad idea to have determined energy using centimeters.
I concede. You are correct, sir.
Thank you. May I?
You may.
Thank you very much for learning with us today. We enjoyed learning with you.
Thank you, Mr. Beck. This was fun.
You're welcome.